I am posting this video on June 6th, 2019, which is the 75th anniversary of the Allied invasion of Normandy, more often referred to as D-Day. D-Day was the largest seaborne invasion in history and was a major turning point during World War II. On this anniversary, we remember and give thanks to all of those brave who fought to reclaim the European continent for liberty. Collectors of United States coinage know that World War II also brought some significant changes to our coinage. Because of the rationing of critical war materials, the United States Mint reduced its use of copper and nickel by changing the composition of the Lincoln cent and the Jefferson nickel. The United States Mint explored various alternative compositions for the Lincoln cent, including aluminum, glass, and plastic. In 1943, the mint settled on a cent made of steel plated in zinc. Although the zinc-coated steel cents could look quite eye-appealing when new, they would quickly oxidize, spot, and even rust. Collectors familiar with well-circulated steel cents will know that they are often very dark and unattractive. Also, being made of steel, the 1943 cents were magnetic and would not work in most vending machines. The many complaints about the steel cents led to them being a one-year-only issue. The example shown here is a well-preserved, superb gem specimen of the 1943 San Francisco steel Lincoln cent, which earned the MS67 grade. The coin has extraordinary eye appeal and a somewhat proof-like fields. By 1944, the mint was able to obtain large quantities of used military shell casings, which they recycled to make new cents. The metal from the shell casings was substantially similar to the pre-1943 composition, although they were often a lighter straw gold color instead of the deeper copper red, and would sometimes have streaks from impurities found in the shell casings, including gunpowder. The used shell casings were recycled by the mint for use in cents until 1946. The example shown here is an amazing 1945 San Francisco Lincoln cent, which earned the MS67 Plus Red grade. The coin is nearly perfect and does exhibit a slightly lighter color than cents of other dates. Nickel was a critical wartime material needed for armor, batteries, magnets, and various other applications. In late 1942, the mint changed the composition of the nickel from 75% copper, 25% nickel, to an alloy of 56% copper, 35% silver, and 9% manganese. The mint placed special attention on ensuring this new silver alloy would be acceptable in vending machines. To mark the change in composition, the silver alloy war nickels were struck with a large mint mark appearing directly above Monticello on the reverse, even for those nickels struck in Philadelphia. This was the first instance of the P mint mark being used on United States coinage. In total, 11 different date and mint mark combinations of the war nickel were minted from 1942 to 1945, and complete sets are in high demand by the collectors today. Although the silver alloy war nickels were quicker to tarnish and would become much darker when heavily circulated, they were similar enough to the traditional composition that they can still occasionally be found in circulation today. The example shown here is a high-end proof strike of the Jefferson War Nickel from 1942, which earned the Proof 65 Cameo grade. Proof War Nickels were issued in 1942 only. Here is an interesting PCGS dual coin sample holder that I had commissioned by PCGS in connection with a presentation on World War II coin compositions that features high-grade examples of each coin. The holder contains a 1943 steel Lincoln cent, which has been graded PCGS MS66, and a 1943 Denver Jefferson War Nickel, which has been graded PCGS MS66 with full steps. The holder also uses the PCGS 30th Anniversary Retro Green labels and references World War II composition set on each label. The labels also reference the sample steel cent and sample war nickel. I did not have many of these sample holders made for the presentation, and because of the limited production and the high-end coins, these special holders have become quite popular among collectors of special slabs. I hope you have enjoyed this presentation on the United States coinage of World War II that I have posted in honor and remembrance of the 75th anniversary of D-Day. I hope that you click the like button for this video and leave a comment for me below. If you are not yet a subscriber to my channel, I hope you will consider subscribing and maybe even hitting that bell icon next to the subscribe button too, which will help you get notice of my latest videos. Thank you again, and remember to keep having fun with your collections.